The Cup is a visually stunning puzzle platformer that is a spin-off game of Golf Club Nostalgia. A golf game set in a post-apocalyptic world where a radio channel is being used as a way of storytelling and at the same time also functions as the game's soundtrack. The radio channel is also included in this game, and while I didn't enjoy every song, I still think it's a pretty creative way of world building and storytelling. Too bad this game has still a lot of narration and in-game cutscenes that felt a bit unnecessary. I feel like this story is already well explained if you just play this game and find some hidden collectibles in the form of newspaper articles, data logs and books that tell you more about this world. In this case, less is more. So it's a shame the same information is being repeated multiple times so often. While this game looks and sounds great and has great animations, the gameplay leaves a lot to be desired. It's pretty basic platforming with barely any puzzle solving. Thankfully, there are a few moments that show inventive game design, and even though these moments could have been executed a bit better sometimes, because of unresponsive controls and momentum issues for example, I really appreciated their inclusion, and they made me enjoy this game a lot more. I really wished there could have been more of these memorable moments, because the core gameplay is just not captivating enough. Even when you are being hunted by these other people and you have no time to think. The overall presentation and the very detailed environments are highly appreciated though. Every level or chapter was aesthetically pleasing, and like I said before, the animations were pretty amazing. The levels are pretty linear though, and all the extra collectibles were a nice touch, but they weren't really that difficult to find. Sometimes three of them were just waiting for you at the same spot in the open. The lack of exploration also harms the overall length of this game. I finished it in 2 hours, and it could have been even shorter if I didn't die so much during this minecart and hopping from bison to bison section. I did miss a few collectibles, but I think it would add maybe like 10 minutes to the total time. So in general, The Cup is a mixed bag for me. I really liked the overall presentation, and the radio channel is still very enjoyable and used quite well to give you a bit more backstory. But the gameplay is pretty generic most of the time, and the controls can feel a bit heavy and unresponsive. I also felt like the story lost a bit of its charm, because the same information was being told multiple times through cutscenes and narration, while the radio channel and some collectibles did a perfect job at conveying the story already. The linear level design also causes this game to be a lot shorter than expected, and that's why I think it's better to wait for this game to be on sale. I'm not saying this game is bad, but it did disappoint me, and it didn't live up to my high expectations. I still recommend this game at full price. If you love cinematic puzzle platformers and you really like the art style and the inclusion of this radio channel. But if you don't, I would recommend to wait for a lower price instead.
As you may well know, the board of directors have founded a club for going on exploratory return visits to Earth.
So be ready to dive into this beautiful post-apocalyptic world and escape from the obsessed hunters while being accompanied by all these funky tunes.